I'm Phyllis Jackson, and this is Stay at Home Connect.
Georgia reaches a record high of over 2,200 newly confirmed cases of coronavirus. The Georgia Department of Public Health reports a 60% increase since the week of June 14th. The average number of cases for a seven-day period has almost tripled since last month. Despite the increase, Governor Brian Kemp says he has no plans to mandate the use of masks or establish any new limits. California will see the mandatory closings of bars and nightclubs in seven counties, including Los Angeles, due to the surge of COVID-19 cases connected to these types of establishments. The increase in reported cases has led Texas to shut down bars statewide. No word on when they will reopen. Texas also hits the pause button on additional reopening plans. Similar moves in Florida with bar closings to slow down the spread of the virus. Also in the Sunshine State, multiple beaches are closing during the July 4th weekend. Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar says the window is closing for the U.S. to curb coronavirus. He announces the federal government has secured 500,000 doses of remdesivir, an antiviral drug authorized by the FDA for use in critically ill COVID-19 patients. He's also asking all Americans to follow social distancing guidelines and wear masks. The European Union is expected to announce plans to ban travel from the United States when it reopens its borders in July. Brazil and Russia is said to be included on that list of countries, all three struggling to get the virus under control. Doctors worldwide believe face masks are a vital part to controlling coronavirus. I caught up with Hillary Warren, an industrial hygienist and senior research scientist with Georgia Tech.
How should people wear a face mask?
Yeah, great question. And we see it even outside of COVID, people just not necessarily knowing how to appropriately wear any of the respiratory protection devices. And every time I see them below someone's nose, I'm like, oh, just a mouth breather, huh? Like, no, you have to have the whole thing. It's really intended to be up over your nose and your mouth. Because the other component is, you know, your nose is a mucous membrane too. I mean, not only are you exhaling through it, but that creates another portal for you. And while we know really the intention of wearing a face covering, any of these non-PPE related ones right now is to, again, keep our own germs to ourselves. It is still a mechanical piece of barrier that's between you and somebody else, right? And it's only gonna work as well as it's being worn.
Councilmember Dustin Hillis provides free COVID-19 testing in District 9 at the Springfield Missionary Baptist Church. Atlanta City Councilmember Marcy Collier Overstreet hosts a food giveaway to assist District 11 residents during the 4th of July holiday.
Glad you could join us for Stay at Home Connect. Have a great night.